Hi, welcome back to my channel. It's MZ here, and this video is another haul video. I've been buying way too much lately, so I'm just going to show you what I've collected over the past month or so. Got some Oracle decks and Tarot decks to show you. So yeah, let's just get started. The first thing I want to show you is something I saw on someone's channel from America. It's these mini, tiny little daily affirmation cards and a tarot deck. They got them from the Dollar Tree in America, and my sister has a friend in America which kindly bought these for me and sent them over, and they arrived like a week ago, and they're so cute, and I'm so grateful that my sister's friend sent them to me. So yeah, they're so cute, and I thought these would be really cool to put in like my charm set that I have. I could mix these in with the charms. And when I pull like some out of a bowl, some cards will come out too. So that's what the little packaging looks like. So if you're in America, get these out of the Dollar Tree. To show you what they look like. I really like this Oracle deck. It's so dinky. Look how cute that is. I really like the style of them. So that's the backs. And they're really like cute. Look, I want you to be here. Free spirit. Feel the love. It's not a bad day. And yeah, they're just so cute. And I just like the style of them. Very 70s vibe. Very happy, cool vibe. I really like it. And I just thought this would be great to put in my charm bag. So I have a few like metal charms and stuff, and I just thought these will make a cool addition as well. Oh, they're so cute, and I'm so grateful that my sister's friend decided to send these out, like, went out of her way just to do it, because she lives quite far out from, like, the post office and that, and she still sent them to me, so I'm very grateful for that. So I'm very happy I've got these. They're so cool. Look how cool they are. But yeah, I'm just so grateful for people that are really nice. Like if I had something in the UK, someone wanted me to send them, I'd happily do it for them. Because I know when you see something online and you can't get it in your country, it must be so frustrating. So, but these are just so cute. And I reckon this will pair quite well with some decks I own, actually. But they're so tiny and so cute. Yeah, I really like these. So, yeah, definitely check out the Dollar Tree. I think that's pretty sure. Over here we call them the Pound Shop. So, we've got one that's local to you. Go for it. They are cute. And this is the Tarot Deck one. And they're bright and colourful as well. I just thought that'd be a cool addition to my charms. They're so small. I love them. Anything tiny is adorable. Like, I really like the colours and stuff. Very cute. I think the Oracle one's my favourite out of this one, but I do like a tiny little tarot deck as well. Yes, yeah, kind of just pip style sort of tarot deck, but I like that they're all multicolored. That's what the backs look like on these ones. Yeah, they're just so cute, and I just really like it. That sun one, that's cute. Oh, that's the Emperor. Emperor looks like the sun, unusual. Yeah, I just thought that was fun, and really wanted them. There's a towel. Yeah, it's just really cool designs. I just really like them. They come in these cute little containers that you can put on a keychain or something. I just think it's just so cute, but my favourite one's definitely the Oracle deck. How cute they are. Be groovy or leave me. So cool. Yeah, and they're quite good little cards as well. I think they'll withstand a charm bag. So yeah, very happy with these. That's the daily affirmation cards. You get 54 cards in that one and a 78 card deck. So, yeah, check them out if you're interested. Sorry, UK people, I might have to find some American friends like I did to get them. But yeah, that's so cool. Another thing I purchased is this. It's the Liberation Tarot. The box has really intrigued me, and I was just like, oh, look at this deck, so cool looking. This is what the box looks like. Quite weirdly drawn to this because it's got it off Amazon, and it's multiple artists in this deck, which normally I'm not really drawn to because they're not very cohesive enough for me, but I don't know, it's really intrigued me and I was just really interested in getting it. So I really liked quite a lot of the cards. This is the book, so it comes with acknowledgements, and tarot teaches us to trust. Liberation is a practice. They get quite a lot of information, and then it talks about card descriptions. And it tells you which artist drew which card. And there's like an image description, then a write-up. And there's further information about the art as well, which I thought was quite interesting. So you get quite a lot of information for each card. I really like that. That's the guidebook. And these are what the backs look like. I really like the backs. And it's got this lovely blue edging. I like that. It's matte. It's really nice. And this is the backs. I really like the backs. They look really cool. Cardstock's really good as well. Quite like the cardstock. It's matte as well. Matte cardstock. And yeah, it's just different. I really like the different artists in this. And yeah, I'm just quite drawn to it. So. Give you a quick view of it. And some, a lot of the titles are renamed. So you've got the artist, the whore, the doula, establishment, ancestors, love, the caravan, courage. I just really like the busyness of some of these. Really like art style, and some of them are quite different, but I like both. I really like that portal card, that's cool. And some are so strange. Accountability, yeah, it just really spoke to me. It's not normally I'd buy a deck like this. I have to get used to the different titles for each card. There's chaos. Yeah, it's just cool. It's really cool. And also I get to find out new artists I weren't aware of. I really like this dream card. And I can find new art and things. And really like the bright colours of a lot of the cards. They're all quite different, but also a bit cohesive as well. Just love the funky colours. Yeah, it's just unusual deck. Yeah, I'm quite happy to get this. Some cards are not my cup of tea, I suppose, but majority of them are. I love that there's a spiral suit. I love the spiral. Oh yeah, it's really cool looking, so. Some of these are a bit out there, aren't they? But yeah, that's quick view of this one that I've called recently, the Liberation Tarot. Another tarot deck I have is this one, the Ferenc Pinter Tarot. I think that's what I'm saying correctly. It's based on an artist's work and they put it into a tarot deck using art he already has. And you might notice that this is a card that Low Scarecrow always have in the title cards and decks, which is quite interesting. And yeah, I just really like the artist. It's quite surrealistic in style. But yeah, you always get this in every time you get a Low Scarecrow deck, and it's by this artist. So, what the backs look like. And cardstock's really nice. It's a good Low Scarecrow cardstock because it's in the two-part box. It's really nice and thick and nice, quite glossy. And the book that comes with it will come in multiple languages with a little write-up about each card. It has a description of the card as well. Then the essence is the meaning. Quite a little, cute little book. Yeah, I actually really like the surrealism sort of style of this. Which was quite cool. I just like the artist's work, and I thought it would be nice to have a deck with a little gallery of his work. Oh, that's quite a strange one for the Hangman. It's just cool. Yeah, I just haven't you worked with this one yet, but I just found it quite interesting. Judgment card. Some lot of booty in this one. I like that Four of Cups. It's nice. Some of them are really quite surreal. I like this one. Very cool. I'm just flick through some of them. Some I'm not here all day flicking through decks. Like that too. I really like this card. Two of Pentacles. Some of these cards are just I'm really drawn to quite a lot. Yeah, if you're interested in this artist, I recommend getting this. So I still need to get the Clint tarot deck because I really like their artwork too. I just haven't got around to it yet. I have the mini, but I don't have full size. I will get it at some point. But yeah, I really like collecting art, like well-known artists and decks and things. I really like this one too. So yes. Another tarot deck that I hold is this one. Interesting to see what kind of readings I get from it. So that's the Laurent Pinter Tarot. The next tarot deck I want to show you is quite a special one. It's the AOS Tarot, which is known as the Austin Osmond Spare Tarot. And on the back it says, in the first decade of the 20th century, the English artist Austin Osmond Spare hand-painted a remarkable deck of fortune-telling cards. Produced in around 1906, this glowing relic of the British occult revival is thought to have been the young artist's personal training deck, and it conveys the excitement and experimentation of a period that laid the early foundations for today's golden era of artist-drawn tarots. Spare's deck has been lost to the world, and to its chance rediscovery in 2013 within the collections of the Magic Circle Museum in London. Has it not been remained hidden from public view for so long, Spare's creation could have significantly influenced tarot's wider cultural development. The deck's design is highly unusual for combining cartomancy and taromancy, and for the complex system of interconnecting visual motifs that link many other cards across their borders. Published here for the first time by Strange Attractor Press in collaboration with the Magic Circle, the AOS Tarot will appeal equally to artists, card readers, scholars and occultists. Now, I just thought this was really interesting because it's a period of history and comes with a little book and it gives a lot of information about the history of Austin Spare. And I looked at them. I missed a Kickstarter campaign, and I got it off a website that they're selling it on. What is it called? Strange Attractor Press website. I'll leave a link in this description. So it gives you a little write-up in the little book. And they try to copy the cards exactly as how the originals were in the museum. Try to keep everything as close as possible, which I thought was really, really good how they managed to do that. So I just thought it was really interesting. Like, all the colours are even almost the exact same with the little marks on the back, like that it was found. And all the cards are different as well. Even got all the little marks that originated from the original. And I just thought it was really, really well done. Now, every card back is completely different, even though they're similar colours. And I just really like it. I think this is quite a special deck. Definitely one for a collector who's into like the history of tarot. And it's really interesting. So he had like upright and he had put reversal as well. Obviously it was like a personal deck that they used and everything. It's just really interesting. It'd be a good study deck to have a look at this. I think the artwork's not, maybe not everyone's cup of tea, but it's the history behind it that I find so intriguing. And it feels so special. Be interesting to see how it reads and everything. But yeah, this is a really cool deck. And it also, I also bought a separate book on this. It's more in depth. I've got it off Amazon. Called The Lost Envoy, the Tarot Deck of Osmond Spare. I'll show you it. And it's really more much big, massive guidebook. So it goes into a lot of detail of this deck and everything. So like this, it's got a foreword, introduction, Osmond Spare and the Ages of Tarot, a work for artists, mind to mind and how by a sorcerer, his own arcana, Osmond Spare and the Borders of Tarot. Tarot cards on a pack in the Magical Circle Museum, the Gift of Fortune, the Deputation, Cartomantic Mirror, Endnotes. And then it gives you actual images of each of the cards in like really nice quality detail as well. And then more notes and acknowledgements and a bibliography at the back. So it really goes into detail about the history and everything. Mentions Pamela Coleman Smith as well. I just thought it was really well done, this book, and it would be great to read about it. I'm just glad I have the deck as well that I can actually physically use. So yeah, it goes into a lot of detail. And it's just really interesting to see a different history of tarot that maybe not a lot of people are aware of. There's a lot of cool imagery. And then here we have actual cards in print. So if you don't own the deck itself, you can have this book and have a print of each of the card. We're intrigued about just the history of it. And I just thought it was really cool. And it's got like different backs as well, and what colours were what that he used for the cards and everything. I just thought it was really interesting. And there's like a meaning for each card, like if you can't read what the writing is on the actual card itself, they've transcribed it in text for you so you can actually understand what it's written there, because sometimes it can be a bit hard to read some of the writing and everything, so they've done that for you. I thought that was quite good. And it's got notes as well about certain cards. I just thought it was really well done, so I'm really intrigued to have a look at this. It does it for each card. Yeah, and there's a lot of history and like letters and to Aleister Crowley, I think that is. Letter from Osmond Spare to Aleister Crowley containing illustration. It appears to show cards being used in a cartomantic reading. So yeah, I just really like this. It's just part of history, and I just thought it was really interesting. So yeah, I'm just glad I have this deck, and it looks so cool. I'll just do a quick flick through some more of the cards. It's good to have a whole video by itself, this deck, but this is something I recently hauled, and I just wanted to show you. And the card looks really nice as well. Really worked with it quite well. Really well made. I really like that card. I love the colours in that one. Yeah, it's just really interesting, and I like to learn different systems of tarot. Like we have Thoth and RWS, and I've got loads of Marseille and Golden Dawn and things. I'm just intrigued what this one has to tell me, which I don't know anything about yet. So it's all completely new to me. I don't know much about the occultist, Austin Spare, or anything like that. Not really. But I'm really intrigued by this. So yeah, this is deck he had, which was in a museum for a long time. And I was just so glad that they was able to recreate it for other people to use. I think that's amazing. So yeah, it's definitely worth a look if you're interested. I'll leave a link at the website so you can get more information. But yeah, that's so cool. So yeah, that's the AOS tarot. So that's all the tarot decks I have to show you this month. The rest are all oracle decks that I've accumulated over the month, past month or so. And the next one I'll show you is this one, the spread deck. This is a second edition. It was on Kickstarter, and it comes with this great companion book, which I thought was quite cool. And you get to be able to write what deck you're working with, and then put your readings in it. It's just like an extra that came with the deck. I've been really into tarot spreads and things, and this deck's been out for a while, but they reprinted it, so I wanted to get my hands on it. This is what the box looks like, and it says, design your own spreads using this new innovative deck, where you pick what positions you want, and you put the cards underneath, and you can read what positions mean on the cards. And I just thought that was really handy to have. And I've been wanting this deck for a while, but I haven't been able to get it. But I'm so glad that they brought it back on a Kickstarter. That's what the backs look like. And quite thick cards. I'm not sure how many cards you get in this, actually. Let's zoom in. Then it says here, let your intuition guide you as you choose the right spread cards to create the perfect layout depending on your mood and questions. Lay down the cards in any order you like, both small or large spreads work great. That's the Instagram. You want to check out their stuff? So I just really like it. So you have like past, present, future. And if you have like a tarot deck, you put it there and you can put the present, so you know that card's for the present position. I just thought it was really handy to have something like this. You have want, need, cause, effect, hopes, fears, lie. There's so many good words, keywords for positions here. Vision, lesson, reward. There's just so many cool ones. All the information's all the same, and there's a matte cast on. It's really well made as well. So I could be like, what advice do I need? And what challenges will I face? And then I could be like, what strengths do I need to overcome these challenges? And what advice do I need to face this challenge, or something like that? And it's just be good to create your own spread with it, and I just really like it. And you can just be like, what's the overall outcome of this? And just keep building on it. And I just thought it was a really cool thing to do. So I really wanted this deck for a while. It'd be good to, because the thing I have with spreads is I'll forget which placement of the spread means what a lot of the time. I have to keep referring back to what position means what, and then I end up disjointed in what message I'm getting. I'm too overworked with wondering what position means what, and then I'd lose my train of thought. And I think this would be much easier to stick to a spread and not get distracted by which card position means what, because it'll have it written on top for me. So I should be like, that's the advice card, that's the challenge card, that's the strengths card, and that's the overall outcome card. And it'll just be so much easier for me, because my brain sometimes gets easy distracted and I'll never know where I am sometimes. So yeah, I just really like this deck. I think it's going to be really helpful for me to play around with spreads a bit more, because I haven't really used that many spreads. It'd be fun to make my own up and see what comes out. Yeah, I really like this deck. It's cool. So that's the spread deck I got from Kickstarter, but I think they have an Etsy that you can get this from too. It's by Holly Nelson. And yeah, it's really cool. And I'm glad I got this spread, so when I play around with my spreads, I can write in this book, so that's quite fun. Yeah, pretty cool. Next deck I got is Your Wise Animal Body. It's an oracle deck for nervous system health in a time when it is needed most. And what drew me to this deck, it's all about your body, and a lot of oracles mainly based on like your thinking patterns, how you're feeling. This one's more physical, which I felt like would be good for my tarot collection, the oracle collection. So like sometimes I neglect my physical health as well, so rather than just looking on the shadow work of the mental mind, I need to look at my actual body as well. So it's a 37 card oracle deck to help you ground, relax, integrate and listen to your wise animal body. Complete nervous system healing tool. And I got this off Tarot Stack website, and I really like the colors in this. Your body is wise, is what it says on the inside. The colors are so bright, and I really, it's my sort of thing. And there's a little message in this there, little focus. I really like the backs, they're really bright and colourful, and they're really cool. This is the guidebook that comes with it. This deck is dedicated to anyone who does not feel totally at home or safe in their animal body due to trauma, chronic stress, illness or pain. I see you, I hear you, I feel you, and I am you. Thank you for all those that were there for me when things got tough. You know who you are. And it's, I think it's the same person that did the Serpent Fire Tarot deck, I think. There's the contents there. So it talks about chakras as well. There's intro. There's quite a lot in this little book. How to use the deck. Notes on trauma. Example spread. Cards that gives you insight about each card, and there's quite a lot on this actually. So like, here's the card Attend, and it's got insight, it talks about chakras and a question, wise body task. And there's like a quote here and a mantra. So there's quite a lot to each card, even though there's only 37. So yeah, there's a lot of information. There's no pictures in this book, but it's all text heavy, which is fine by me. You get all the information you need. So it goes into each card like that. And it talks about the nervous system. Gives you a little bit of information about that as well. So I thought that was interesting. Notes about the author. And you might note yourself in the back if you want to. So this is what the backs look like. Really bright and beautiful. I love the like pastel purple gilding. I think that's really, really nice. So we have Attend, Awaken, Attend Core, Attend Ground, Attend But I think that's a tend love, a tend say, a tend unify. Then you have authenticity, bear down, boundaries, daydream, deep breath, ebb, ground, integrate, listen, meditate, mindful movement, nature, pleasure, release, rest, ritualize, rove, I think that says, scent, see, shadow, yawn, slow, stretch, I always forget to stretch, always, taste, tighten and loosen, touch, bagel breath, vocalize, void, and wash over. I really like the look of these. The colours really draw me into this deck as well. And I think it's nice to have different purposes for different cards. So I'd be interested to work with this and see how it helps me physically. So I just really like this one. I'm intrigued by it. So that's the Your Wise Animal Body Oracle. Another deck I got with a kind of purpose, but something I don't really have, is an Art Magic, an Inspiration Deck for Creativity by Molly Roberts. Been really into painting at the moment, and I thought this might help move my creativity and inspiration for creating artwork. And obviously it's another beautiful, colourful deck. It's for the back of the box, looks like it says, answer the call of the art witch with a kaleidoscope of creative inspiration. Enter the realm of art magic with this vivid inspiration deck. Unleash your inner art witch and cast creative spells with earth, air, fire, water, and ether. Bring your blazing desires to life. Be lifted by breezes of intuition. Swim freely in the creative flow. Engage with the enchanted world and revel in the playful wisdom of the rainbow. This imaginative deck will awaken the creative magic that lives within you. And yeah, it's really, really spoke to me because I feel like when I do art, it's type of art magic process of mine, that it's like a magical process. I think art is magic. So it comes with a little leaflet here about how art and magic work together and how to use the deck and everything. And there's elemental helpers and about the magic of colour. Yeah, I just thought it was really cool and interesting and something different. And the back's all really colourful, really like the colour spectrum of the cards, all so beautifully done. It's just really inspiring to look at in itself. So matte cardstock. Did notice when I got this though, it was slightly bowed, which is hopefully will flatten out over time. That's one thing I did notice. So on each card it has a keyword and then some questions to prompt you. Like this one says, desire, what plucks and sounds the strings of your secret self? What gives your heart a genuine succulent thrill? That sort of thing. So you can just shuffle one of these cards and see what brings to mind and what art you can make from it. And this one's play, like you can play is powerful, turn loose on your kaleidoscopic spirit with fun and make-believe. Just like have a play with your art supplies. Everything doesn't have to be a masterpiece. It's fun to just try out new things and see what things you learn using different media and stuff. And then there's inspiration, synchronicity, not magic, create your new opportunities, weave a healing spell, record your journey, awaken the art witch, riding lunar waves, symbols of power, focus pocus, and it says unlock the element of air, celebrate spills, flow, embrace impermanence, restore your mind, body and spirit, incubate dreams, ancestral connection, scrying. This one's interesting. Summon the curious seeker within and consult your intuition. Throughout time, mystics have sought answers in the gleaming surface of polished stones, bowls of water, moonlit lakes, and magical mirrors. Explore guerrilla scrying on the fly to enhance meditation, develop intuition, and receive inspired guidance. So, like, if you scry, you can, maybe an image will come to your mind and you want to paint it or something. That's just really interesting to me. This, I thought this would be fun to use. And there's unlock the element water. There's a lot of cool things I can do with this, which will get my inspiration going and have fun with some art magic. So I really like this. We have Earth. Change the game. Illuminate your aspirations. Amplify your charm. Inspired action. So yeah, it's just a really cool deck. And there's lots of things you can do. Conjure a sacred space. Empower your tools. Tools are living spiritual collaborators. Plug into the beauty of animated universe by recognizing the power of your tools. Console them with names, history, personality, and notice their inherent wisdom. Transform your tools into magical allies through meditation, ritual, close observation, and vivid imagination. So I could do that with a paintbrush or pen or whatever you like to do art-wise. About unlocking the element fire. I think that's a really interesting deck and really like that. So that'd be cool to play with, see what sort of art I'll create with this deck. It's another fun one to try out. That's the Art Magic Oracle deck. Another deck I got is the Sacred Symbols for Divination Meditation Oracle deck. I really like the simplicity of this one. It's a 50 card deck, and on the back it says, "Create with the highest intentions. Sacred Symbols Oracles designed for those seeking clarity and guidance. This deck can serve as support for meditation as a path to magic and sacred symbology." I think what drawn to me this deck is it's got symbols I could use as a focus point. So if I was focusing on air or something, I could go to this deck and put this on my altar and have it as a visualization of air as well as having other things on. And I just thought it was quite interesting. And here's a little book for it. It says you can use spreads. Threat protection, divine masculine magic, new life. It talks about each card and everything, what it means. You get a little write up. For each one, which is nice to see. There, you have really like the look of this one, so you get like full moon, safe travel, talisman. I just really like the simplicity of this one. Been out for a while, this one. I really like the look of it. Courage, veiled, water, nature spirits, meditate, time, transmute. Yeah, just a little cool, simple imagery that I could focus on and use. Fire, earth, boundaries. Sometimes just a simple deck is all you need to get the messages you want. I really like symbols and everything. Maybe I could combine it with my art magic. I could pull one of these out and incorporate some sort of sigil of new life into the imagery of art I'm making or something like that. Be interesting to play around and see what information I get. And I really love this card growth. I have a tattoo for the same reason, spiral tattoo, because it's all, to me, is all about your, as you grow, you spiral out and you learn and you grow. I really like that card. Yeah, that's the sacred symbols. Another oracle deck I got is this one. It's a new release by Rebecca Campbell. It's the Ancient Stones Oracle. It's got 44 cards in it. So a deck I wouldn't normally get, but I do still have some of her other decks. And this one intrigued me because it's about ancient stones and I love crystals and all that sort of thing. So there's information here. And then comes a guidebook as well. That's not my typical art style. Like, from photo manipulation isn't really my thing majorly, but I do like some of the cards in this. So it comes with an introduction and talks about folklore of answers for the stones, ancestors, that sort of thing, different spreads. And it gives you information about the oracle. What's this? Ancient Stones Oracle Attunement. Okay, so an extra card. Water card to richly connect with the oracle or positive ancestors. Oh, okay, so it's like a guided sort of meditation sort of thing you can download. That's quite interesting. How to read the cards. Deepening your devotional practice. And you can use the actual the box itself as to hold the cards up, which I probably won't do, but you have that option there if you want to. Go through spreads and that. And then you get a little picture of the card, keywords, and a write-up about where the imagery comes from. This one talks about Stonehenge in England. And then activation sort of quote there. And it talks about different stones in history, like the prehistoric ancestors from caves and things. So I think it was quite interesting. I liked that approach to this deck, so that's why I got it. So sort of guidebook looks like. Now, you do like some of these cards, they are quite pretty. I like that it's got a keyword and a little message at the bottom as well. I think that's quite helpful. I really like that one. I think it'd be quite fun to use. It's a matte cardstock, and it's pretty good cardstock as well. That's what the backs look like. I'm not sure if there's a lot of talk that the Rebecca Campbell's going to have like a deck for fire and air as well. She also has like an ocean one out, and this one's like the earth one. I don't know how true that is. But I just really like this one because I really like rocks. I'm one of them weirdos that go to the beach and be like, oh, let me look at the rocks. I want to collect some rocks and bring them home with me. My boyfriend thinks I'm a bit strange for that. But I found a hagstone when I last went to the seaside, so I was quite happy I found that. I was like, yeah. So I was very happy. So yeah, I do like my rocks. I reckon as a child, if you gave me a bag of rocks as a gift, I would have been ecstatic. Oh, there's a hagstone card. That's cool. I like that. What did I do with that hagstone? Let me try and find it. So yeah, this is what I found at the beach like the other week, and I was world happy about it. And I brought it home with me with a couple of other rocks that I found interesting. So yeah, I really like stones. They don't have to be fancy, shiny crystals or anything. I just love rocks. I don't know why, I just do. So yeah, that's why I bought this deck. So just like the theme of it. And I reckon it'd be quite a fun reader. Like, I do like some of our other oracles as well. I prefer the oracle decks rather than tarot made by Rebecca Campbell, actually. I do find them more useful to me. I don't know why. Yeah, the artwork's not that my sort of thing, but I do like the theme, I suppose, behind it. But there are some pretty cards in here. Yeah, I just really like the look of this one. See how it reads. Singing Stones, that's cool. I like that one. Yeah, I just think it's full deck. I'm excited to work with it. So yeah, that's, oh, I like that one. The Wisdom Keeper card. It's pretty. So yeah, that's the Ancient Stones Oracle. Another Oracle I got is what a repurchase, but this is an extended version. This is the Old Ways Magic Oracle by Naomi Cornock. And they added extra cards to this deck, which I was very happy about. I think it was only about 30 cards before. I'm not exactly sure how many it was. I've got it somewhere in the drawer. I should probably compare them. But now it comes with like a cool guidebook. So you get 50 cards now, which is cool. And then gives you an introduction. And it's really nice quality paper as well, quite thick. You get an image of it, and welcome, warning, and wisdom, and a little bit information of the keyword. And I'm just glad it's been extended because I really like the art style, and I feel like having 50 cards is good for an oracle deck. I'm glad I got this one. So let me just show you some of the cards. We have Sacred Journey, Unity, Protection, Cardstock Wires. It's quite, really quite nice. Feels a bit linen-y actually. I don't know, it's got a texture to it. It's the back. I love the back. So cool. Yeah, it feels really nice. Hope, Spark. It's very pagan feeling artwork, I feel. But so beautifully done. Look at this reading card. It's stunning. Really, really, really magical. It's like you're going into a new fantasy land. It's so immersive, they are. I really love it. Rebirth. Connect. New. Elemental. Playful. I'm not sure which cards are new or if any old cards have been changed. I need to compare, really. I need to sort of just got this deck, so source, look at that. Look at the colours. So much detail in this. It's so beautifully done. I just love the artwork. Strength. Leap of Faith. Sovereignty. Growth. Got the Green Man. It's a beautiful card. I love that. Quite slippery in the hand though. Really nice cards. Nurture. Liminal. Just trying to focus in on the beautiful detail of this artwork. Absolutely beautiful. The camera doesn't give it justice. So much detail in this. That's what I love about this artwork. It's just magical. Oh, I love that card. So nice. Yeah, I really like this deck. I'm trying to think what I'd pair it with. You got any suggestions? Let me know. So it's a beautiful deck. I'm just glad I have more cards because having just over 30, I think it's like 33 or something, was just not enough for an oracle for me. So I'm glad there's 50 now. I still will keep the other deck because I'm a collector in me. Cleanse. Battle Ready, that's cool. Artwork's amazing, I love it. Omen, Death, Grief. So it does cover a lot of areas, which I like. Contemplate and Journey's End. Look at that detail. Wow. Really stunning artwork. I love this. So this is the Old Ways Magic Oracle by Naomi Cornock. Absolutely beautiful artwork. And the last deck I want to show you is this one. It's the River Oracle by Nick Bentock. It's got 48 cards in this one. And they also done another deck that I own. I can't remember what it's called now. But on the back it says, master the intuitive language of images. Swim through your subconscious with this stunning deck from the New York Times bestseller author Nick Bentock, featuring 48 surrealistic cards that feed your imagination and personal mythology. The river teaches you to think intuitively with images rather than words. In the colour guidebook, each card's interpretation is designed to help you with new meanings within each reading. Whoever uses tantalising ambiguous deck on its own or with the Archeo, yeah, that's the deck I have. Bantok's first deck, these cards will redefine your response to the language of pictures and expand your notions of magical realism. So yeah, what drew me to this deck was the surrealist art, and I want to play around more with my intuition. Look at this beautiful box. Stunning. I really like the colours of this as well. So, get the cards out. I love any deck that makes me work with my intuition more, because I do heavily rely on guidebooks quite a lot, and I like using soul cards. And that new deck I got that I showed you, Immerse Yourself Oracle, that was it. You and I Immersive Oracle. That's meant I do the same sort of thing, so I was always on hunt for a deck like that. So this is what the guidebook looks like. It's nice and glossy and beautiful colours inside. Gives you introduction. Spreads and talks about the cards. And each one represents a season, so the spring is 1 to 12. It gives you, in the guidebook, it gives you a keyword, like a title card, and then gives you a bit of information about the card. But there's not a lot in here, because it's trying to base it on your intuition. And I think it goes through each season, I think. So, yeah, summer cards are 13 to 24, so you get like 12 cards for each season. Autumn, and then you get winter. So it just has a little write-up for each card in here and suggested questions that you might want to ask, which is quite cool. It talks about the cycle of seasons. And there's other books that the author has made. Interesting to know. So yeah, like the backs of these cards are very cool, like ink, and they're shiny glossy cards, like thick cards and quite large. This one also has a slight bow to it, which is hopefully will go away over time. But yeah, there's a number in the corner of each card, so you know what number the card is. But anything surrealist, I'm drawn in instantly. So it's my sort of, anything surrealist or abstract is my thing. And I love, adore this artwork. Wow, look at that one. Amazing. So unusual artwork. I love it. Very out there. I love that one. Wow. So it's very mixed media, a lot of different sort of art styles in this, which I like. Some of it looks collage, some of it looks like acrylic or oil painting. Very beautiful. I love layered media. So interesting to me. So yeah, I thought this would help with my intuition a bit more, because I do doubt myself quite a lot. I don't feel like I have the confidence within myself. I always feel like I need to look at the guidebook to check if what I was feeling was right, which is silly, because your intuition is enough, I think. But I just don't trust myself. Wow, look at that one. I love that one. It's beautiful. It's really, really detailed. Beautiful, beautiful artwork. I like that the numbers are not detracting from the artwork so much, which is I like that. But yeah, it's really cool. I prefer this one to their other deck they made. I think this one's really, really cool. Those are quite a different few styles in this. I quite like it. I love these ones though. Splash of colours, and that's just absolutely stunning. I love it. So yeah, I can't wait for this as well. I need to find a deck to pair this with now. So cool. I'm glad that it's got 48 cards. Anything lower than 44 is not ideal for me. So that's the River Oracle. That's all the decks I've hauled recently. I've only recently done another haul, and I just keep buying more and more decks. There's just so many that I want in my life. So thanks for watching, and like and subscribe if you like my videos, and feel free to let me know if you're intrigued by any of these decks, because I absolutely love hearing your opinions on things, and any recommendations, gladly let me know. Yeah, thanks so much for watching. See you next video. Bye.